Today's short video on the T-Bird 2000 MTS-2000 will be Fiber to the Home OTDR. From the main screen on my T-Bird 2000, I've selected Fiber to the Home. It's highlighted in yellow. I'll go ahead and click it and launch it. When I do, I'm going to go up into Setup. Now, once we get into setup, we have a number of things that we need to make sure that we have set up properly. The very first selection we have up there is laser, but I'm going to jump down to number two real quick, direction. Now, typically when you test fiber to the home, you're testing from the ONT to the OLT. Now, I can test from the OLT to the ONT. However, I caution on that. If you're shooting 1x2, 1x4, 1x8 splitters, you can typically view those test results. Once you get anything over a 1x16, you start to see all of the legs coming off the splitters. It makes the OTDR trace extremely busy and difficult to interpret. So we typically test from the ONT to the LLT. I'm going to jump up here to lasers. Now, if this is a new install, which is what we're working on here, I can test 1310, 1550, and my filtered 1625 nanometer wavelength. I'm going to do all three. However, I caution, if this is an active pond network, if you shoot anything 1310, 1550, 1490, you're going to take service down on all the users that are on that network. So the purpose of having a pond meter is having the out-of-band wavelengths so that you can shoot an OTDR to troubleshoot back the opposite direction and not affect traffic. In this case, I'm going to shoot all three. Now, the third one down is number of splitters. Well, heck, I may not know how many splitters are supposed to be out there. If I don't have the engineering sheets and I know exactly what's out there, or I'm on a trouble report and I don't have that information, then I can guess, or I can have the T-Bird 2000 do the work for me. So I'm going to select Discover. Now in this case, I don't have a launch cable, but if I did, I could select launch cable and I could put in the length, whether it's 20 meters or whatever you're trying to use. Same thing on the receive cable. My distance unit. For this case, since it's fiber to the home and it's a relatively short link, I'm selecting feet. But typically when I'm out in the real world doing OTDRs, I'm a kilometers kind of person, except fiber to the homes are typically a lot closer, so I'll go with feet on that. Next one is index of refraction. Now, every fiber that has been installed in your plant comes with an index of refraction, and that's the speed of light within that given fiber when it was manufactured. Now, chances are you probably don't know, and if it's existing fiber, you probably really don't know what the index of refractions are. So we have 18 presets for the different manufacturers out there. My go-to one that I typically use all the time is Corning SMF28. Single mode fiber 28. It works for me, but if you know exactly what you have out there, you can put that in. If you don't and you have one that works for you, that's fantastic. Now I'm going to hit my bottom right button, top menu, and I'm going to jump into alarms. Now when I do pond here in the US, I use for my pond thresholds, I use G.697/G698X PON. Now, if you know exactly what your spec is, if you're an IEEE PON, or if you know what you're supposed to be using, you can make that selection. But here in the US, I typically use G697, G.698 PON. And below that, I can see all of the default settings that are for that threshold. When I drop down the link, this tells me if I want to save my test results, what exactly do I want to include in those test results? So I have my OLT ID and I can click on that and I can come in there and I can say, hey, what do I want to include? In this case, I'm simply saying, hey, I want my OLT ID in there. The same thing for my ONT. I can include my ONT ID in there. If I have a distribution ID or a fiber ID, I can put that in there. Now, fiber number. If I'm doing one fiber, I can simply put in fiber number one, run my test. If I'm doing a turnip and there are multiple fibers, then I may want to start with fiber number one, and then I'll change my fiber numbering to increment. And this way, every time I save, I'll increment from fiber one to fiber two, fiber three. Or if I want to, say it's a 96 fiber, and I start at 96, I may want to decrement, so I'm going to work my way backwards. Really comes down to whatever you want to do and however you want to save your results. You can put your technician ID in. You can put a comment in. Back to the top of the menu. And underneath file, where exactly are we going to save this? Right now, my naming directory is my current directory, and I'm going to stick it under my disk, demo, and fiber to the home folder. Now my result storage is file naming. So if I click on that, I have ONT ID and my date and time, but I can change that. My file content, I have all traces. I could say just put one trace in there, or I could say, hey, since I'm doing multiples, I want to put all my traces in there. Do I want to do auto store? Every time I run a test, do I want to store that? I can say yes or no. In this case, I'll say no. How do I want my reports to come out? In this case, I said, hey, I want text, PDF, and JSONs. But I can go in there and turn those on or off, whichever way I want to go. My report layout is standard or consolidated. If I say standard, every time I save, I'm going to get an individual test. If I'm doing a bunch of fibers, I'd like all those consolidated into one report. Now, at the very bottom, it says include microscope image. In this case, I don't have my microscope on there, so I'm going to say no. Go back to the top of the fiber. I've got everything configured for the way I want this test to run, so I'll start my trace. Now we have the OTDR test completion, and by default, we come up into what we call SmartLink. Now, if we look at SmartLink, SmartLink works on what we call SmartLink icons, which makes it very easy to interpret the test results. However, I don't necessarily get all of the results and things that I need, so I can move over to the trace view to get more in-depth analysis. But if I come over here and I see this very front-end cable right here, and I hit event view, I'll get a pop-up that says, hey, this is my front-end connector. From the front of the front-end connector, 37.16 feet out, I have a 1x8 splitter. Then I go about 1,810 feet out to a connector, and then to my fiber end. If we look down at the bottom, it gives me all three wavelengths that we shot, 13, 10, 15, 15, 16, 25. They all have green check marks, which means everything looks good. I can see my total link loss, my link ORL, my fiber links for each section on the fiber, and my average loss per kilometer, dB per kilometer. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to jump up here to my trace view. Let me zoom and change this up a little bit and make this a little bit simpler to see. So at 1310, we can see our front end connector 38 some feet out there. We see our 1x8 splitter. We can look at our loss there at 10.427 dB. I can look at my reflection of neg 80 and my section length of 38 feet. And so I can look at everything right now up here underneath number one at 1310. That's my lowest wavelength. If I jump up to 1550, again, I see the same things, and I see, you know, I see things in green up here. I see my 1x8 splitter. And if I drop down to 1625, again, I'm seeing all of my different views down here now with my loss, my reflections, and things like that. And I'm able to look at certain things and get a determination. Since I have my alarms turned on, I get things in green and red. So if there was something off, I would be seeing that. Thank you very much.